Hi everyone. So, Clare and I are doing a get ready with me for senior portraits today. I look really better now, but I just washed my face and stuff, so my skin's a little dry. We're just gonna be answering questions, all that type of jazz. And I'm probably just gonna do like my face makeup, maybe like 10 minutes of footage, but mostly for the Q&A portion. So let's get started.
Hey Wave Crew, so it's currently like 10 something a.m. And I'm just about to start my, well, I actually did start my senior portrait makeup. I accidentally forgot to film an intro, so here I am. Very classic of me, but all I did was put on a little bit of concealer, and that's basically it. I took a shower this morning, so that's why I'm looking kind of busted, but we're about to fix that soon. So with that being said, let's just get started.
I think the first question is something valued, or I literally made the questions and I don't know them, or me if I make them again, but. I literally forgot. Oh, the first question was best memory of living in the dorms. Okay, I'll say this. There's a lot of times I'll look at like Snapchat memories or like people will send them to me and I'm like, that's not me. Like living in the dorms is just a different life to say the least. I don't know, there was just a lot of weird stuff going on. I guess a good example to show is like the third vlog we just choked my spit, but the third vlog that we uploaded, that was still like mild because that was the vlog where me and Clare were like, oh, we should start trying to like show us like more normal, like the funny stuff that we do. So like I think it'll be like the pickle situation in that vlog, and there are like some like jump cuts at the end where like we would say something or do something funny. I don't know if y'all ever noticed, but yeah, it's just really weird. And then you get really close with the people that you live with. Not close in the sense of like, well, you do get close with them just like emotionally, but just like sharing the bathroom and stuff, things like that. Obviously like nothing too extreme, but it's just like, oh my gosh, that's not me. I don't even know what to say.
Oh, I kind of already started the concealer, but first question is best memory from living in the dorms. There's so many, but I'm just gonna name the top three off the top of my head. One of them was, like after school, Adriana and I had this thing where we would literally just like play Just Dance anywhere from an hour to 2 hours per day, like right after school. And it was just really fun, but I think I had a lot of fun when one day we decided to ask our sweet mates Carly and Fiona to join us, and so we played like What Makes You Beautiful by One Direction, and I forgot the other ones, but it was really fun. I'll insert clips so you guys can see. But another one was, oh, one time I had to go to the printer like early in the morning because the other printers were closed, so I wanted to get there first and like get it out of the way. And I woke up early that morning and all of the alarms in my suite were going off, like every single person's. And it was so loud, it was literally like ringing down the entire hallway. I felt so bad for everyone living in our wing. And so I go downstairs to print and I come back and they're still going off, and it was just, yeah, it was really funny. I also recorded clips of that. OMG, I look so scary because I don't have any eye makeup on. I'm working on it. But next question is something I've learned in quarantine. I think something small is, something small is using my mom's sewing machine. Oh, it's next to me. That's why I was looking at it. But learning how to sew on my mom's sewing machine, it's actually very useful. Like, it's a very useful skill. So I'm glad I got to learn that. And I think something bigger is just learning slash realizing to take time to myself, whether that be self-care or just getting extra hours of sleep. Like, junior year Clare would have definitely stayed up the entire night finishing up homework or essays or whatever, but senior year Clare, maybe it is a mix of senioritis too, but senior year Clare would go to bed early, make sure she gets all her sleep, and then wake up the next morning and finish her essay before class. So yeah, I appreciate that. I'm really appreciative that I got to learn that, because I feel like my life has improved a lot since realizing that.
Okay. Pretty sure the next question is something valuable you've learned in quarantine. And let me tell you guys, quarantine has been an up and down thing for me. But for the most part, TBH has been pretty good. Well, as good as something like this can get. But anyways, whenever I got in quarantine, MSMS third quarter was rough for junior year. Not even necessarily like school is necessarily like so hard, but there's just so much stuff. We have like the ACT, and then like trig started, and then I don't know, the classes were just heavy, workload was heavy, and all that stuff combined with a little bit of ready to get on with summer, it just ended how it did. So TBH, I think that extended period at home was something I needed, because like I had been, oh my gosh, this sounds so deep, but take this with a grain of salt, but I feel like I had become so consumed in like the MSMS environment that I like needed to come back to like myself. This sounds really personal, but anyways, yeah. But then after being at home for a while, I kind of just liked it. But that was also because we have like, I don't even know what it's called, flipped classroom. And we just like did everything on our own pretty much with like a few Zooms. Long and short, being at MSMS, like in an environment that's kind of like college, similar, whatever, that's like away from home at a younger age, I'm really, really, really glad I had that experience before I went to college. Because it's something that you just can't understand unless you're in the environment. And I can't imagine not having this like pandemic break, which sucks to say because we're in a pandemic, but I don't know what I would have done if we didn't have this break where I could like rethink everything that happened and like, you're like, oh, this was good, this was bad. Okay, this question is, what do I look forward to for the rest of senior year? TBH. I'm excited to graduate. I can't believe I'm a senior. It's crazy. I can't believe I'm a senior, but like, I don't know. I'm the youngest in my house, so I can't believe. Yeah. That's my answer. The secret to surviving MSMS. Okay. Overall, biggest tip is be your self and address it whenever you feel like not being yourself. Do what you want when you want. Because opportunities are always gonna come around. You make your own success. I don't even know if that made sense, but.
Oh my gosh, I feel like I change way too much each clip, but. Anyways, next question is, the secret to surviving MSMS / misreporting part of MSMS. I feel like, I'm sorry if you hear the construction work outside, I can't do anything about it. But I feel like the secret to surviving is just kind of figuring out what schedule works best for you, or what works best for you in general. I know I went through this period where I would like stay up really late doing homework, so then to replenish sleep, I would just go to bed right after school, or like I take a really fat nap right after school, and then I'd wake up at like 7, 8 p.m., sometimes even 9, and then just do all my schoolwork over and over again. And as absurd as that schedule sounds, it was actually extremely beneficial for me, because before that, I would like not get enough hours of sleep every night. And yeah, it just didn't work out. But after I implemented that new schedule, I got all the hours of sleep. I got majority of the hours I needed, and I was still able to maintain my grades and everything, and just maintain myself in general, to be honest.
Okay guys, I'm going to go now, and I'm really sorry. I'll see you guys right before I leave. Hopefully I remember to vlog right before I leave, because Clare and I always forget to, and then all of a sudden we show up at the school. But yeah, I shouldn't forget. I'm gonna finish my makeup because I need to hurry, and yeah.
Hey guys, sorry for the bad lighting, but the last question of the video is rate your makeup. I didn't really like my makeup when I left my house, but I think it looks okay now. Probably give myself an 8. I don't really care. That sounds bad, but some of you might know what I mean. Oh my gosh, the lighting's really bad, sorry. But I feel like whenever I take pictures, they just happen to turn out okay. So I'm worried, but I'm not worried. And I'm just in the parking lot now. I'm waiting for my mom to give me the money for the proofs, because she forgot to give it to me before she left the house this morning. So yeah, and also let's ignore the fact that I said that I would vlog before I left Columbus. I mean, I left Starkville, but I'm in Columbus. So yeah, I'll see you guys when I'm with Clare, I guess.
Hey Wave Crew, so basically I forgot to film this clip, and I already took my senior portraits, and now I'm already back home. But to rate my makeup look, I think I'd give it a solid 9 out of 10. 0.5 taken off because I had a little bit of glitter fallout, which wasn't noticeable unless you were like super close to my face, but also would have just been nice if it didn't happen altogether. And I think the other 0.5 taken off was because earlier when I first finished my makeup, something was off and I just wasn't happy with it. And I still cannot pinpoint what it was, but there was just something not right. But I made a few alterations, and then after I did my hair and everything, I think I felt like better with the overall look. I think I did a pretty good job for my liking, so that's good. But that's basically all. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and please stay safe and follow all guidelines, and see you next Wednesday.